Welcome back dear students for the next session. So here we are going to discuss about the continued part of the simple epithelium. Next we have pseudo stratified epithelium. So when we basically talk about this pseudo stratified epithelium, let me tell you that although this layer is made up of single layer of columnar cells, it is having single layer of columnar cells. All right, so this you have to note down, children. Okay, see, I have already told you that the epithelium is classified into two types, that is simple epithelium and compound epithelium. Simple epithelium, all the types will have the single layer. Okay, so whereas the compound epithelium may have more than the single layer, many layers may be present. Fine, so this is one aspect. Next, let me tell you that here some of the pseudo stratified layers, all right, are shorter than the others. Some cells are shorter than the other cells, and let me tell you that the tall cells which are present here in case of pseudo stratified epithelium have nuclei at different intervals. They don't have nuclei at only in a particular region of the cytoplasm. That can be present in different regions. Okay, say now let me draw a rough diagram. Say this is what the the pseudo stratified epithelium looks like, you know, a rough structure. See, we know that it is having the basement membrane, all right. So here, as I said you, some cells look very short and some look very long. See, nucleus may be here or here, or different intervals, as I said you. Okay, it is not present in one region of the cytoplasm, all right. All right, so this is what, again, the cells, this is how they look like, all right. And you know, this is the pseudo stratified epithelium. Okay, see, you have certain gland cells as well here. Okay, let me, they have glands. Okay, they have glands in them. So these cells are called gland cells. So they help in secretions, all right. This is one aspect. And see, as I said you, this is the basement membrane. This is the basement membrane on which the cells lie. Okay, and below the region which you can find, this is the connective tissue. All right, so this is now about what we can say the structure of pseudo stratified epithelium. So I said that the tall cells have the bigger nuclei, and at different intervals you can find here, all right, in different intervals or different cytoplasmic regions you can find, dear students. And the tall cells and the short cells are present. Actually they are all single layer but look like double layer. That's why it is called as pseudo stratified epithelium. See, furthermore, let me tell you, the role of gland cell is what we can say. We can also say these gland cells as the goblet cells. We can also refer this to as goblet cells. And we know that the goblet cells are important for the secretion of mucus. All right, so that is the role you need to remember, dear students. Moving ahead, we have two types of pseudo stratified epithelium. The first type is pseudo stratified, all right? The first type is pseudo stratified columnar epithelium, all right? Then secondly, we have the pseudo stratified ciliated epithelium. So let me repeat. First type of pseudo stratified epithelium is pseudo stratified columnar epithelium, and the second type we have here is pseudo stratified ciliated epithelium. See, note 2 points here. In the first type, the pseudo stratified epithelium is made up of columnar cells. In the second type, it is made up of ciliated, all right, the cells. Okay, the ciliated, you can say pseudo stratified ciliated epithelium, or you can also say pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium as well. Okay, they are also columnar cells, but they bear the cilia on their free surface. Okay, fine. So now coming to the first, that is the pseudo stratified columnar epithelium. All right, here few points we need to note down, dear students. All right, see, I have already told you their division when I did the first class. Okay, so follow the same division of the epithelial tissues, that is how the simple tissues are divided and how compound tissues are divided. Fine. Now here, in this type of pseudo stratified columnar epithelium, see, we can find the columnar cells without cilia. They don't have the finger like projections called cilia. This is 1 point, dear students. And they have large ducts of glands. Large ducts. The ducts are nothing but the storage sites, okay, of glands. All right, dear students. Now let me tell you, for example, say you have a type of salivary gland called as parotid gland, okay, and urethra of man, from which you know the urine passes, all right, and then we also have respiratory passages. In all these regions, dear students, we can find the pseudo stratified columnar epithelium. Okay, so columnar epithelium, all right. So this is what you need to remember with respect to the first type. Now moving to the second type of pseudo stratified epithelium, we have pseudo stratified, all right, ciliated columnar epithelium. Ciliated columnar epithelium, right, which I have already told you. Here it is made up of again columnar cells only, all right, but these columnar cells will have cilia on their free surface, all right, students. Okay, here one contrasting point to note down is that, see, short cells, they generally don't possess cilia, so cilia is absent here, all right, whereas the long cells, all right, will have the cilia. So where do we find this type of pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium? See, in the lining of urinary tract we can find, to go with that, even in the lining of trachea we can find, all right. So these are the important aspects you need to remember with respect to the two types of pseudo stratified epithelium, that is pseudo stratified columnar epithelium and pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium, dear students. Now functions of this pseudo stratified epithelium is that they help in protection all right. And also in the movement of the secretions which are present in the glands, because here we have ciliated generally epithelium, okay, so that cilia helps in the movement of the secretions from the glands, as these are majorly present in some of the glands. So the secretions which are produced from these glands can be transported to the site of action, okay. So this is about the pseudostratified epithelium. Dear students, so we have completed with the first type of epithelial tissues or the epithelia, that is the simple epithelial tissues. Now the second type we have is compound epithelium. So in the first we have completed both the types and the subtypes. In the first, now we are starting with is the compound epithelium. This is the second type of epithelia or compound. We call this as compound epithelium. So dear students, let me tell you a few important points here. First of all, see, this compound epithelium, as we know that they have few to several layers of cells, all right, they have few to several layers of cells. This is the first point, okay. So we did not find many layers in case of the simple epithelium. We found that it had only one single layer of cells, but here in case of compound epithelium we find few to, all right, several layers of cells. And note the point that the compound epithelial cells are much thicker and as well as stronger than compared with the simple epithelial cells, all right. Then furthermore, let me tell you that these cells, okay, especially the deepest layer of, because many cells are present, so the deepest layer, all right, only will rest on, all right, the basement membrane, okay. In case of simple epithelium we found that almost all these, because they are single layer, so all the cells will lie on basement membrane. But here it is not the same, only the deepest layer sits on to the basement membrane. Basement membrane is a non-cellular membrane on which the cells lie, okay. And these cells generally divide by the cell division called as mitosis, okay. And after undergoing mitosis, no, many cells will be formed. So these cells, you know, give rise to many layers, okay. The outside layers are, they form many layers, dear students, okay. Let me repeat the point. See, the deepest layers which are present will undergo mitosis, so many, that is the cell division, so many layers will be formed outside because of this cell division. Alright, now because of the same reason, alright, the lowermost region which has the cells lying on the basement membrane is also called germinative layer. We also called the deepest layer also as what? Germinative layer, because it is helping in the formation of many layers. Furthermore, dear students, let me tell you that these compound epithelium, where it is present, all right, and what is its role, okay, and what are its type, we will understand. Before that, let me tell you that the compound epithelium covers the surfaces where constant replacement of cells is seen, all right. That means we call, it may be replacement of cells may be due to wear and tear, all right, due to friction, all right, the cells may die. We call that as wear and tear, all right. So wherever wear and tear we find, okay, there we can find compound epithelium, because their new layers should keep on forming. So This compound epithelium helps in the formation of those cells. All right. And rather, see, in simple terms, we can say that compound epithelium is multi-layered. I hope you can understand. Here, multi-layered means it is made up of many layers. And generally, let me tell you, it does not have an important role in secretion and absorption. Now, in case of the first type what we studied, the simple epithelium, most of the cells had the role of secretion as well as absorption. Right? Here, these roles are minimum, or in fact, we can say very little role, or these roles are absent, we can say. Alright. Now, further, let me tell you that these compound epithelium help us, you know, in avoiding the mechanical, alright, chemical, as well as thermal and osmotic stress or injuries due to this they will avoid, or stress which can arise to our body due to the mechanical injuries or the chemical injuries or thermal and osmotic injuries may be avoided because of the compound epithelium. Dear students, next we have types of compound epithelium. Alright, so general points with respect to the compound epithelium we have discussed, that is the major one of that is, you know, they are made up of many layers, cell layers. Okay, so here we have two types. Okay, the first type of compound epithelium is stratified compound epithelium. Alright. And secondly, we have transitional compound epithelium. Alright, so these are the two types. Alright. Now here, first type, let us now understand. The first is stratified epithelium. See, stratum, stratified, the word is derived from Latin. Okay. So from Latin it is derived. So stratum means to say here layer. Alright. So the name itself says layer. So here we can understand that this stratified epithelium is made up of many cell layers. Alright. The first point you can note down, dear students. And let me tell you that the deepest layer is of these cells, the deepest layer. I shall show the diagrammatic representation as well. So the deepest layer, it is made up of cuboidal or columnar cells. Cuboidal or columnar cells. Alright. Deepest, the most inside layer which is present in these tissues is formed of the cuboidal or columnar epithelium. See, and cells of outer layer or the surface, they vary in nature. Alright, they may be of different types, but the different types which can be present there have many roles. But here with respect to the deepest layer, only two, that is cuboidal or columnar, we can find. Further, let me tell you that stratified epithelium is classified on the basis of outer cell layer into four types. The first type of compound epithelium is stratified epithelium. So, on the basis of outer cell layer, right, because of I just said you that they have different types of cells, based on that, based on the nature of this outer cell layer of compound epithelium, we have four types. The first type we have is stratified squamous epithelium. Alright, this is the first one, stratified squamous epithelium. Then secondly, we have stratified cuboidal epithelium. Okay, this is the second type. And thirdly, we have stratified columnar epithelium. And fourthly, dear students, we have stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Ciliated columnar epithelium. All right. So remember, I said the deepest layer, the base cells are made up of either cuboidal or columnar. But here, outer cell layer in case of stratified epithelium can be either made up of squamous epithelium or cuboidal epithelium or columnar or ciliated columnar epithelium. So these are the four types of stratified epithelium we have. Dear students, next let us move with the types of stratified epithelia. Okay, so here let me tell you that the first type, that is the stratified squamous epithelium, when we see it looks as such. Say there is a membrane, okay, as such. Okay, here we can find many cells lying like this, okay. Then many layers you can find, okay. So this is one, okay. So this is the connective tissue at the lower end, alright. So this is the connective tissue, and this is the basement. This is the basement membrane of the stratified squamous epithelium, and they have a big centrally placed nucleus. Almost all the cells, now I am representing here, will have a large centrally placed nucleus. Okay, fine. Then above this, you know, layers, you can also find one more layer of transitional cells like this. Okay, all right. So they also have nucleus at the center. Then further, okay, we have here, you know, all these cells are extended here, okay. Fine. So these cells, the outer cells, the outer layer will have the cells, we call these cells as the squamous epithelial cells. See here, these are squamous cells. That is, the outer layer is made up of squamous epithelial cells, alright. And there is a basement membrane, and below the basement membrane we have a connective tissue, alright. And the lower cells, now let me tell you that where basal cells are present. Basal cells, this is the basal cells. This lower layer, alright, what I have marked here, okay, are basal cells. So I told you that basal cells have the ability of undergoing cell division to give rise to many layers, as you can observe, alright, many different types of layers of cells are formed. That is because of the division of the basal cells. This is how, you know, the structure of stratified squamous epithelium looks like. I told you we are classifying the stratified epithelium based on the outer layer. So outer layer first we are discussing is stratified squamous epithelium. So outer layers is here made up of squamous epithelial cells. See, these cells do not have intercellular spaces, alright. And innermost basal cells, we know that these basal cells can be either columnar or they can be cuboidal, alright. So which will be same most of the time, okay. Then, dear students, now further let us understand the location where we can find this squamous epithelial cells. See, generally I told you they cover the surface of buccal cavity, alright, of the mouth. Which is present. Buccal cavity is a part of the oral cavity of mouth. Okay, so there the surfaces are covered by stratified squamous epithelium, and also it covers the pharynx region, alright, which is a common passage for the ear and foot to pass through, which is pharynx. Okay, there lining we can find stratified squamous epithelium, and also in esophagus, which is called as the foot pipe, in this lining as well we can find the stratified squamous epithelium, dear students. Okay, now further this stratified squamous epithelium is also divided into two subtypes, that is stratified squamous keratinized epithelium, alright, and stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, alright. So it's very simple, let me tell you. Here keratinized, what it is representing, let us understand. See, keratinized here it is representing in the presence of hard waterproof, alright, protein called keratin in them, whereas in non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium we don't find the keratin. So keratin is here absent. This is first point you need to remember. And furthermore, dear students, see, they have various functions, alright. First let me tell you, this hard waterproof protein called keratin, which is present in the keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, so we can find the process of formation of this keratin as keratinization, alright, or we can also say that to as cornification, alright. These two terms you remember, one is keratinization and the another one is cornification. When this deposition of keratin, especially this keratin is deposited in the cytoplasm of the cells, alright, due to which the cells will die. When this keratin is deposited, when keratinization or cornification occurs in the stratified epithelial cells, the cells will die. Okay, so generally let me say that these dead cells which are filled with keratin are referred to as stratum corneum, alright, or you can also represent it to as the horny layer. So this stratum corneum, that is the dead cells, alright, filled with keratin or horny layers, can be present in different regions, and generally it is maximum in the sole of our foot, alright. So this is the one. So what is the location of this stratified keratinized squamous epithelium? So they can be seen in the epidermis of the skin, covering of the skin, we can find this type of stratified keratinized squamous epithelium, alright. So functions are that it does not allow, you know, any movement of water, alright. So it is, we say that as impervious to water, and it is highly resistant to mechanical injuries or abrasions, alright. Mechanical injuries or any abrasions which can be caused to the body, any tissue damage which can occur due to mechanical injuries, that can be avoided because of this stratified keratinized squamous epithelium, dear students, alright. So these are few important aspects with respect to the stratified keratinized squamous epithelium. So moving ahead, second type we have here with respect to the stratified squamous epithelium is stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium. As I said you, in this second type we don't find the keratin, all right, the water insoluble protein which was present before in the case of keratinized. Here in non keratinized squamous epithelial tissues under stratified we don't find keratin, dear students. Okay, so we find here instead of that, you know, the cells are living, so living squamous cells we can find. So because this is the first type of stratified epithelium, that is based on the outer layer of cells, that is squamous cells are present, so we have classified as the first one stratified squamous epithelium, right? So there in this we can find the living squamous cells. The cells are not deposited by the keratin, so they are living, all right. And where do we find this non keratinized stratified squamous epithelium? See, we can find in the lining of buccal cavity as well. Here also in the buccal cavity we can find, in the tongue, all right, we can find, as well as in the pharynx, the common passage for food and water, there we can find. Even in few regions of esophagus, that is the food pipe as well, we can find. In the vagina we can find, in the female, that is a part of the female reproductive system, all right. Then as well as in the few parts of urethra, the common passage for urine and semen, all right, in case of males we can find, all right. So these are the locations of stratified non keratinized squamous epithelium. So let me repeat, we can find them in the buccal cavity of mouth, in the tongue, in the pharynx, in the urethra of males, esophagus, that is the food pipe, and female reproductive system, a part called vagina, there as well we can find. And what are their functions? They also protect from aberrations. So this is about the first type of stratified epithelia under compound epithelium, that is stratified squamous epithelium, dear students. So the second type of the stratified epithelia we have is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. So dear students, let me tell you here. See, the outer cells here are formed of, as we discussed before, here the outer cells are formed of the cuboidal cells. Cuboidal cells. Alright. In the first one, what we discussed, that is stratified squamous epithelium, there the outer layers were made up of the squamous epithelial cells. Here in case of the second type, the outer cells are made up of the cuboidal epithelial cells, all right. And let me tell you, this can be generally, this the location is generally in the sweat gland ducts, all right, sweat gland ducts, that means where the sweat gets stored after its secretion, those ducts are lined by the stratified cuboidal epithelium, dear students. And let me tell you that even the epidermis, the outer surface of the fishes, is also formed of this type of epithelium. So the functions are, they also protect us from mechanical and chemical damage. So this is about the second type, that is stratified cuboidal epithelium. So the next type we have is the third type of the stratified epithelia. We have stratified columnar epithelium. So again, on the basis of outer cell layers which are present, we are classifying this stratified epithelium, right? So here the word itself suggests us. So this stratified epithelium, which is made up of the outer cells, which are made up of the columnar cells, is called as the stratified columnar epithelium, all right. And further, the location of these cells we can find in the epiglottis. All right, in the epiglottis, in the what I can say, the tracheal, before the tracheal region starts, the epiglottis where we can find, you know, in that region. All right, and also the lining of it can also be present in the lining of mammary gland ducts. The mammary glands is a characteristic features of all the mammals. So the mammary glands secrete the milk which are stored in its ducts. So those mammary gland ducts are also, you know, the lining is formed of the stratified columnar epithelium. Okay, and in few parts of urethra as well we can find this type of tissue. This also performs the role of giving protection against mechanical and chemical damage. So let us move on to the next type. So we have the next type as the stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. All right, so it is made up of the ciliated columnar cells in its outer surface. Okay, that's why the name is been given as such. So now location of these cells is in the larynx. Larynx is the voice box where voice will generate. All right, so this larynx lining we can find this type of epithelium, and also upper part of, all right, upper part of soft palate. So in the oral cavity we have hard palate, that is the roof of the oral cavity, and the floor of the oral cavity is called as soft palate, where tongue lies. So that floor of the oral cavity we call soft palate, their lining is formed of stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. And let me tell you, dear students, the functions are here is protection, all right, and also it helps in driving the material in a particular direction. That means if any dust particles or if any other, you know, foreign substance of, if they enter the body, they, you know, pull to the particular region where from there they can be expelled outside. All right, so these are the four different types of the stratified what we can say, the epithelium. Dear students, so let us move on to the next type of compound epithelium, that is transitional epithelium. So till now we discussed was about the first type, that is stratified epithelium. Under them we have discussed four types, and the second type of compound epithelium we have is transitional epithelium. All right, this is a type of compound epithelium. Fine, so here how it differs from stratified epithelium, let us discuss. See, it differs from stratified epithelium in having lesser number of cell layers. All right, cell layers are very high in case of the stratified epithelium, that is the first type of compound epithelium which we discussed. Now here in case of transitional epithelium, the number of cell layers, different cell layers which are formed in these tissues, are lesser than that of the first one, that is the stratified epithelium. All right, so we can say that it is much thinner because of the presence of few layers. It is much thinner when compared to the stratified epithelium. All right, because of that it also has great flexibility, dear students. Now in case of transitional epithelium, see, let me tell you that it looks as such. See, only few layers, let us say for example we have, this is the first layer of cells what I am drawing, okay, then followed by this first layer, okay, there might be one more layer. All right, so as you can find here, see, I have drawn only here two layers, but in the case of stratified epithelium you found many layers, isn't it? Right? So let us say these are a type of cells called as polyhedral cells. Polyhedral cells, all right, and these cells are columnar cells. Alright, so only these are the two types cell layers which we can find. These polyhedral cells are oval in shape, columnar cells are like pillar like or column like we can find. Okay, so this transitional epithelium looks as such, like this, only few layers we can find, but in case of stratified epithelium we can find many layers. Alright, so further, dear students, here generally the basal cells, the lowermost cells, are generally made up of either columnar, as I showed before in the diagram, okay, or cuboidal cells, and the upper or the surface cells, again it may vary. Alright, so anyway, dear students, so the location of these cells we can find in the lining of organs, where which organs which have the ability to undergo expansion, like for example ureters have the ability to expand, all right, and urinary bladders, because it stores urine, all right, so they have the ability of expansion in these organs, as well as in certain renal pelvis we can find these type of transitional epithelium. So it is also essential, dear students, to understand the functions of transitional epithelium. Okay, so this, as I said you, it helps in considerable expansion, dear students, where I have already told you, alright, so in the urinary bladder, ureter and renal pelvis, so due to which we can find the stretching of cells, okay, stretching of cells can be present, alright, and because of this it also accommodates urine, alright, more of urine can be accommodated because of the expansion or stretching of cells. And also, dear students, transitional epithelium prevents the more loss of water, alright, from blood to urine. From the blood to urine there will be minimal loss of water, okay, because of the transitional epithelium, alright. Then further, it also helps in, you know, preventing the urine from escaping into the surrounding tissues, alright. So it may cause many other metabolic problems if it escapes to the surrounding tissues, which is avoided by a type of epithelium, the second type of compound epithelium called as transitional epithelium. So we have done with all the types of epithelial tissues. So there we discussed about the simple epithelial tissues and compound epithelial tissues. Under them, all the types and subtypes we have discussed. Dear students, next, moving on, we have the last topic here for in today's class, is that general functions of epithelial tissues, general functions of epithelial tissues. So we have completed all the discussion on the types of epithelial tissues. So here we are going to discuss the function. So first is protection. So in what way the protection is provided by the epithelial tissues, let us understand. See, epithelial cells of skin and trachea. We know that the skin and the epithelial tissues of trachea are exposed to the air, and where chances of loss of water is possible, but this is avoided because of the epithelial tissues. So loss of water from the skin and trachea, which is exposed to the air, more exposure we can find here. So their loss of water is avoided by this epithelial tissues. That's the first point. Okay, and protection is also provided in the from the mechanical injuries, okay, as well as from harmful chemicals also, the epithelial tissues provide the protection. To go with that, it also gives protection from UV light, alright, which can cause damage to the tissues, and in severe cases it may also cause cancer. So it gives protection also against the UV light, alright. So this is the protective function, that is the protection, okay. First function is protection. So the second function we have is sensation, alright. So here let me tell you that it helps in sensory stimuli. That means to say that, you know, it receives the stimuli from the environment and convert it into the nerve impulses, alright. These nerve impulses can be passed to the brain, alright. Then we have the reaction, okay. So it helps in sensory stimuli, that is receiving the stimuli from the environment and convey it to the central nervous system in the form of nerve impulses. So this is the second function, that is sensation. Then third function we have here is secretion, alright. So secretion, we know that in the glands the epithelial tissues are present, so which secretes various components, like it may secrete mucus, alright, enzymes, alright, for fast reactions of our body the catalysts called enzymes are required, okay. Mucus also is important for so many functions. Hormones, that is the chemical messengers, alright, intercellular message to send, we need hormones, so which is secreted by the epithelial tissues in the glands, as well as certain lubricating fluids are also present in certain regions of the body. So this is the third function, that is secretion. Then dear students, the fourth function we have is absorption. So now with respect to this, let me tell you that certain epithelial cells which are lining the small intestine, alright, have microvilli in them, alright. So microvilli are present, the finger like projections, which help in the absorption of the digested food and water. Moving ahead, the fifth function we have is excretion, alright. Here the epithelial tissues, especially which are present in the kidneys, alright, that is the excretory organs, it helps in elimination or excretion of various nitrogenous waste and all the other waste products. Otherwise, if it is not in fact eliminated, it may be reabsorbed into the body and may cause many metabolic disorders, dear student. So this is the fifth function, that is the excretion. Next, moving ahead with the next function, we have sixth function, that is diffusion, alright, of the epithelial tissues. So here especially the simple epithelium helps in rather the diffusion of gases, alright, liquids, as well as other nutrients, alright, which are required for bodily functions. Gases, liquids and many other nutrients can be transported, alright, in the different body parts with the help of diffusion. So diffusion is also an important function of the epithelial tissues. Then let us move on to the next function. The seventh function we have here is conduction. So I have already told you, you know, all these functions in general we have discussed, but in particular we are discussing now, okay. So here this conduction function, especially by the ciliated epithelium, alright. That means to say that ciliated epithelium helps in the movement of fluid, mucus and other materials in the body, alright. Or for various bodily functions, this movement is necessary, which is provided by Alright, the ciliated epithelium, dear students. So this is the seventh function. Then moving on to the next, that is, we have the next function as the epithelial tissues reduces friction. Alright, so due to friction, you know, the blood or the walls of blood vessels, alright, tunica externa, tunica interna, tunica media, the walls of blood vessels may get damaged, right? So it avoids the friction, alright, and also that is the friction between the blood is moving with pressure inside the blood vessels, so the friction between the blood and walls of blood vessels it avoids, so that the damage of tissue, especially the walls of the blood vessels, can be avoided from the injury or damage. So this is the eighth function. Moving on, the next function we have is, it also helps in reproduction, dear students. See, that means it helps in the formation of gametes or sex cells. Gametes can also be represented as the sex cells, or in particular we can say them to as sperms or eggs. Sperms are the male gametes, alright. So male gametes, the symbol is represented as such, and the eggs are the female gametes. So in the females you give a plus mark, okay. So it's like, alright, this, alright. So these are the reproductive function. So they form the germinal epithelium in the testes and the ovaries, which helps in the formation of the gametes, right? This is the ninth function. Then moving to the tenth function, alright, they help in, alright, acting as barriers. So they act as selective barriers, the epithelial tissues, alright. So here they facilitate only the passage of substances which are required, alright, and they do not allow the substances which are not required. So this is selective barrier function of the epithelial tissues. Then moving ahead, so we have pigmentation. So what I am saying here, all are the important functions, almost all the major functions we are discussing here. So make note of all these functions. So pigmentation, see, especially it imparts dark color to the tissue of retina, alright. So that pigmentation function is also performed by the epithelial tissues. And the next function, they also help in regeneration, alright. That means when the tissues or cells of our body are damaged due to mechanical or physical injury, alright, so there the epithelial tissues help in healing of wounds, alright. So this is also an important function which you can make note of. Further moving ahead, we have contractibility. So this is also an important function. See, it helps in the contraction of mammary glands, alright, and to go with that, contraction of salivary as well as, you know, sweat glands, alright. You know, by this contraction, the mammary glands will release the milk, salivary glands will release the saliva, and sweat glands will release the sweat. So that contraction can be brought about by this epithelial tissues, alright, dear students. So this is contractibility function, so which is in fact, sorry, here it is the 13th function, okay. Then let us discuss one more function. The last function which we are discussing here is, it helps in the formation of exoskeleton, alright. So in what form? So it helps in the formation of scales, alright, claws in animals, alright, and it helps in the formation of feathers in many birds, right? It can also help in the formation of nails, horns and hooves in animals, all right? Horns and hooves, all right? And also it helps in the formation of enamel. Enamel is the hardest part in our body, the upper part of the teeth we call enamel. So it also helps in the formation of enamel. So these are the few major functions of the epithelial tissues. So till here, dear students, we have completed the simple and compound epithelial tissues. So that completes the epithelial tissues itself. So thank you very much for your patient hearing.